Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
Delicious things to eat.
The popcorn can't be beat. The sparkling drinks are just dandy. The chocolate bars and nut candy. So let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat. Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
Hi, hello everyone. Gosh, what a beautiful audience we have. We have people with all different colored hairs. We got Kermit the Frog. Couldn't ask for a better view. Hi, my name is Phil, and I'm one of the characters you're about to see in this show. Welcome to Manifesto Theater's What Happened to Tyler Bowen, an audience interactive murder mystery comedy farce directed and written by Will Engel. Now, before we start, the Bowens have a couple rules that they'd like you to follow. Rule number one, you are welcome to take pictures of the cast and crew. Well, if you can see the crew, that would be kind of weird, but still. But please, no flash, as it might scare our characters, especially Noah. Rule number two, if, and only if, you would like to participate in our volunteer section when it comes up, please know that you must get up close and personal with our actors, so make sure you're comfortable with that. Rule number three, please silence your cell phones, because if we hear it ring, we're going to ask you to answer it and put it on speaker. No one wants that. And rule number four, this is an audience interactive play. If you want to scream, if you want to holler, if you want to get up and dance, if you want to give me some money, I'll take it. Feel free to do whatever you would like. That's enough for me. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy What Happened to Tyler Bowen.
Y'all VIP. Let's kick it. Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air.
Somebody once told me the world is going to blow me.
What's
that? I'm going to
show
in the shed.
This
is shit!
I'm sorry, Mom.
Rule number one of birthday parties. Birthday boy doesn't know how to do any work.
Well, Tyler, you
suck. Oh, hey, Marsh. Probably. Don't worry about it. I'll deal with the boxes and just check on the drinks and pizza. Merci beaucoup for helping.
I didn't know you spoke French, Francis.
Oh, I learned it in a commercial. So, why don't we continue setting up?
Fine. But it feels wrong to keep all of his guests waiting.
Look how many people showed up.
Yeah, I don't know. That guy always gave me the weirdest vibe.
Francis, I'm sure he's a very nice person. Actually, never mind.
Hey, Dimitri, why don't you get down here and help set up for your brother's party?
Dimitri, those were expensive!
Oh, fuck.
Mom. Mom. Tyler. It's good to see you all again.
You were just down here in his bathroom, Dimitri.
Well, that's besides the point. Hey, everyone. Here for the Christmas party?
Dimitri, it's the middle of July! And it's my birthday.
Well, that's besides the point. I've got to go to the bathroom.
Go, rule number one.
Darius! It's so great to see both of you.
Oh, Tyler. Francis, Marmalade, Darius!
Bill!
Good, thanks for having us. Christmas party, right?
How do people keep getting this wrong?
Is Dimitri here?
Yeah, he's in the bathroom.
Must be taking the coolest shit ever for the coolest guy ever.
All right, all right, all right. What does Dimitri have that I don't?
Style.
Class, good work ethic.
And a nice ass to top it off.
Okay, 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 jeez! You don't have to rub it in my face, Mom.
So, you invited all these people, huh, Tyler?
Yeah, that's right, Phil.
Look, I get that you don't have many friends, but you really invited him? He gets off the weirdest vibe.
Honestly, it was a pity invite.
I'll get it! Madison! Brandon!
Darius! It's so good to see you!
Darius! Bill! Tyler! Marmalade! Francis! Madison!
Brandon.
Thanks for inviting us to your Christmas party, Todd.
It is the middle of July!
So does that make it a Kwanzaa party?
Hey, Pat, long time no see.
Oh, Francis! Marmalade! Madison! Bill! Darius! Brandon! Tyler!
Hey, Pat, here for the Christmas party, I assume.
Excuse me? I am not an idiot. It is the middle of July!
Well,
it's a Thanksgiving party, right?
You know what, Pat? I'm gonna go get some chips.
Hey, everybody's here.
Really, Dimitri?
You have to make such a grand entrance into every room.
A true superstar makes every room a red carpet.
I thought you'd learn after what happened at the New Year's party with Cody. Oh.
Well, that's besides the point. Is everybody here?
I think the only person missing is Noah.
Noah! I did!
Oh my god! You guys are so mean to Noah! Do you really think he says, oh, I'm doing enough to make his catchphrase or something? He doesn't say that! Noah doesn't say that!
Shut up, Pat. It's just a joke.
Yeah, a joke based in fact. Up, up.
Okay, well, since just about everybody's here, do we want to start the party?
Actually, there's one more person I'd like all of you to meet.
Are they already here?
Yes. They are my...
And now, dear viewers, lend me your ears, for if not, thine eyes may be in tears. We require a brave soul among you all to take part in our farce and has the gall. One of thou will receive the prize to expose thyself before our eyes. So indulge us, fair audience, for this performance is participation, and join us in our situation!
There's one more joke.
I don't think you understand Shakespeare.
Yeah, well, fuck you. Anyways, you know what? You get it. You get the prize. What's your name, buddy?
Hi, I'm Troy.
Troy, and what are your pronouns?
He is and him.
Perfect. Come on up.
What are we just going to have you stand right there?
Boyfriend. This is my boyfriend!
What? Not that, Tyler. Hey.
Madison, do you have a crush on my brother?
What? No, why aren't you? I'm gonna get some chance. Tyler, I told you you're not allowed to date until you're 35.
I'm sorry, Mom, but we are in love. Come on, Troy, babe, tell her how we met.
Well, it was the Christmas party like 2 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
Normally, embarrassing photo.
Yeah. Let's kind of want to relive that. We were all a little tipsy. Yeah, we were hallucinating. The booze was strong.
We were hallucinating. I felt like this.
We were under the mistletoe, and one thing led to another. Even when we sobered up,
we loved each other.
Yeah, even we loved each other when we sobered up.
There was love, Mom.
Well, that's the stupidest story I've ever heard. All right, Tyler, you can keep it.
My life is over.
Well, why don't we get this party started?
Sounds good to me.
It's not your birthday, Dimitri! Actually, Mom, I've made a big choice. I'm not going to college.
Tyler, you fucking moron! You were supposed to be the perfect child! Now, I just have Dimitri to depend on.
Well, that's besides the point.
Yeah, see, he won't stop saying that over and fucking over again. You are in big trouble for this.
Hey! Don't worry about it. I mean, now that you're not going to college, you won't be taking the TV.
Actually, Mom, I already sold the TV.
What? Tyler, my TV? Oh.
So, Dimitri. You can help me with my chemistry project this weekend, like you said?
No can do, Brandon. I'm hanging out with Tyler tonight.
What?
But you always hang out with Tyler! But this is my future worth talking about! Can,
Can't you spend one night away from your brother?
Well, geez, Brandon, I'm sorry, but family comes first. As long as Tyler's in town, I'm gonna be with him.
I thought you were my friend, you damn eggplant! But Tyler ruins everything. Madison! Get off of me! I am in a relationship!
It was just a tickle, Tyler! I'm not allowed to do that anymore now that you've got a stupid boyfriend.
No, you're not allowed to do that anymore. In fact, I always hated it when you do that.
When you go to college, I think I'll never have to see you again.
No!
Oh, thanks for getting me in on this, Scott.
Yeah, sure thing, Pat.
Even though Tyler's the one getting on the inside of things, since he's a secret—
Oh my god! Why don't you guys just stop saying that, huh? All you guys do is joke about Tyler being a secret agent, and it never stops! He doesn't do that! Tyler doesn't do that!
I'm just joking around. Calm down.
I can calm down when you dickheads are always joking that Tyler's a secret agent, or that Tyler's my mom! I checked, and he isn't, so you know what? I think we know who won there.
There's a man that you can piss off. Well, Tyler, I'm gonna miss you when I'm off in college.
Thanks, D. You know, in a twisted way, I think I'll miss you too. Huh.
Hey, you wanna duck out of here for a second? I have some animations I've been meaning to show you.
Some
animations? God, he's so cool!
Actually, right now it's not really a great time, but maybe later, pal.
Why not now?
Well, I gotta be really honest with you, Dimitri. I was on your computer a while back doing totally normal things. Google, Yahoo, Fache Book. And I wiped it clean. It's all gone.
What?
I'm sorry, Dimitri. I don't know how it happened, you know? It was smooth sailing. The seas were calm, and then all of a sudden, bam! Rough waters, and it was all gone. All of it. Wiped clean.
That was my life's work! I could kill you!
What? It's just an expression.
Tyler? What was on that computer?
Normal stuff. 100%.
Normal. I'm sorry. Adam, I'm sorry. No, I'm not going to.
You were watching something called gonzo porn on my computer! That was more important than my animations!
Oh, God. Oh, my own son, watching porn! It's a tragedy, honey! Oops.
When we're done here, I want you to go into my bedroom, get the magazines out from under my dresser, and burn them all.
What even is gonzo porn? I can't believe my future husband was watching it.
Oh!
What is it?
Oh!
Skip was gonna be gonzo the Muffin, but somehow that is much worse.
Hey, Marmalade, do we have any drinks?
Yeah, there's punch and other things in the back room.
Quan Chi.
Hey, excuse me?
You know, Quan Chi, it's something you say when you're happy. It's really in right now.
Quan Chi.
I'll get it. Noah! Thanks for coming!
No, I'm not.
Oh, dude!
One time. He said it just one time.
Oh, hey, Noah! Be careful up there. I just washed the floors.
Oh, dude!
Oh, he doesn't do that!
Alright, well, this is a great party and all, but I have some business to attend to, really. But come on, babe. Let's go.
Just sleeping. He had a knife in his neck.
Well, fuck me sideways, he's dead.
And he finally got picked off by an enemy government!
Tyler wasn't a secret agent!
Well, he's not anymore!
Wait! If there was a knife in his neck, that means he was murdered!
Dun, dun, dun.
And the killer has to be one of us!
Damn it, Demetri, we were talking about a serious issue!
Couldn't have been more important than me.
Your brother's dead, Demetri!
Oh my god.
Poor Demetri must have loved his brother so much. Look at how
he- This isn't Sprite, it's Mist Twist! This is garbage!
That's not necessary.
Anyways, what were we talking about?
Tyler's dead.
Oh.
What are you going to do?
I want to sit down.
I wanted Tyler to love me.
I want a drink.
Oh, dude.
I want to go home.
I want to find out who did this.
I want you all to be quiet. What we have to do is calm down and think logically. Shouldn't we call the cops? No, dear. What we need to do is figure out what happened to Tyler Bowen.
She said it!
So what is this? Some kind of murder mystery or something?
I've never liked murder mysteries. They've always come across as campy and silly with no real substance. And just an onslaught of crude jokes.
Hey, Darius.
What?
Penis.
Nice. I doubt that'll happen here.
That's besides the point. How can we uncover the killer?
Brandon said it has to be one of us.
But how can we know that?
Well, there's no way anyone could have gotten in here without anyone noticing.
That's true. While you guys were all gone, I was out here with the rest of these guys.
I bet it was him, the one with Mr. Weird Vibe!
Oh, no! I don't think it could have been him. He was out here while I was.
I can't believe someone would kill my future husband.
Don't play innocent with me. You had a motivation to kill him.
Ooh.
What are you talking about? I loved Tyler.
Ooh.
I bet you knew he would never go for a trashy girl like you and thought you would kill him so no one else could have him either.
Ooh.
You try to start something, you old shit.
Oh.
So bitch.
Stop fighting! This is exactly what the killer wants. For us to be at each other's throats. Besides, Maddie, there's another Bowen boy ready to rumble. My safe word is that's besides the point.
I would never settle for anyone besides Tyler. I would never kill him.
Monolith's right. You did have a motivation to kill Tyler. In fact, we all did!
What do you mean?
Think about it! Bonnelly was mad at Tyler for not going off to college. Dimitri had his animations deleted by Tyler. Madison didn't want Tyler in a relationship, and Pat was mad at Phil and Darius for joking around about Tyler, and Phil and Darius, well, they're just assholes.
Yeah.
And Frances wanted her TV back.
And you were mad at Dimitri for spending too much time with Tyler.
Well, we know it couldn't have been me. I was out here the whole time. And you guys can vouch for me.
Yeah?
Well, I bet you all snuck out together to kill my baby boy.
It would have been a big hassle for one night.
I can't argue right now. What we need to do is look for evidence and then make a conclusion based upon that evidence.
Sound pretty smart, Brandon.
I watch a lot of Law and Order.
How should we start?
We should split into groups and look for clues.
Sounds like a reasonable plan.
I watch a lot of Scooby-Doo.
I think Brandon's got the right idea. We should look for clues in here. Tyler may have left something before he went up to his room.
Yes.
Oh, dude!
Did you find a clue?
No, he signaled his finger.
How does that cat get through the day?
I heard he doesn't know his marks.
Anything?
Well, I found a couple papers, some paper clips, and ooh! I found my sunglasses!
Oh,
I can't see shit anymore.
Did anyone find anything important?
We'll have to go to the fill route.
We should split up into groups of two. That way, if the killer is one of us, we can't have them going out alone.
That's a good idea. I'll split up the groups since we know it wasn't me. Phil, you go with Brandon.
Hey.
Darius, you go with Madison. I'll take Carmelite. And Pat, you take Noah.
Hey! Well, why do I get stuck with Dr. Staple Thingy?
I get the impression that you're the only one who knows how to deal with him.
Yeah, you guys were best friends for the longest time, right?
He's still my best friend.
How do you even communicate with him? All he says is odd, dude.
He doesn't even say it that much! Okay? I don't care what you guys say.
Oh, dude.
Well, then let's go.
Wait, but someone has to stay and entertain the guests.
Alright, you really don't want to take Noah. You can stay and entertain everyone. Would you guys like that?
Yes! Fine. I can handle myself.
Oh no, Pat. You're coming with Darius and me.
If you kill my tie-dye, you're paying with your life!
Really, Maddie? Tie-dye?
I have a whole book of names for him. It's for when we get married.
You'll be marrying a corpse.
Better than Dimitri.
Oh, hello! Dude.
I am the coolest kid in town, alright? You'd be lucky to have me.
I'd be lucky to have you!
Well, that's besides the point. Why doesn't Pat come with me since I don't have a partner?
Fine.
Better than this necrophiliac.
I'll take that as a compliment.
There's literally no way you could take that as a compliment.
Don't worry, Pat. You're safe searching with me.
No. I'm not hugging you. No. It's not a good moment. This isn't. No. I'm for my love.
Shh! Why do you smell like cheese? What the fuck? No.
Yeah. I wish that were me!
So there I was, in the middle of the greatest mystery of my life. The clues were sparse.
Everyone in the room looked at each other with silence. What's so funny?
Accusing stare.
My work as a detective had begun. Today, I was Sherlock Holmes, uncovering the mystery of the eldest Bowen brother. Could the killer really be one of us? Or was something more sinister going on? I began to analyze everyone in the room, looking for any sign of guilt, or...
Does he normally do this?
Only every other Saturday.
Hey, Brandon, you're doing great, but we really gotta start looking for clues.
Oh, right, I'm sorry.
Hey guys, hands in the middle. Let's start looking for clues.
Yes.
One, two, three.
Tyler!
The Tyler's killer.
When I was a young boy, my father took me into the city to see a marching band. He said, "Son, when you grow up, will you be the savior of the broken, the beaten, and the damned? Because one day, I'll leave you."
Come on, dude.
Classic Noah.
Dimitri, why do you have so much
strength?
Is everyone here?
Not everyone. Where's Phil?
Phil was looking for a few things under the bed. Maybe he found a clue.
So where did everyone look? Marmalade and I checked the basement.
Madison and I checked the kitchen and your room.
Phil and I checked Tyler's room along with the body.
Thad and I checked the garage.
Did anyone find anything?
Back to square one.
Oh! Phil found some magazines under the bed and we analyzed the body.
I swear to God, those magazines are porn.
It looked strange, but I don't think it was more porn.
Well, tell Phil, merci beaucoup. What's that?
It's French.
Her name is Francis.
I can't help to be suspicious of Phil, though.
Why would he want to be in the room with the body?
Maybe he's the necrophiliac.
I think Pat's right. There's something suspicious about Phil wanting to be alone with Tyler.
Okay, well, let's keep that in mind. Brandon, anything notable about the body?
Not the body itself. There was quite a bit of blood on the bed. And the killer must have hit a vein or something.
So there's no way the killer couldn't have gotten blood on his nose.
It was Noah!
Oh, dude!
That ugly fuck did it!
Okay, wait! Remember? Phil spilled punch on Noah's shirt. That stain's not blood. It's juice.
It's right. I saw it happen.
Okay, but what if the blood got on top of the punch?
Honestly, I think Noah's too stupid to commit a murder. No offense, no.
Oh, he's right. He has the IQ of a potato.
Come on, dude.
I heard he doesn't know the alphabet.
Let's try and piece some more clues together, like how Phil could be involved in this.
Oh, he could have changed his shirt after he killed Tyler. Wait, I hear footsteps. He's coming. Everyone act casual.
What are you all doing?
Acting casual!
You aren't supposed to tell him that!
We're not doing much. What are you doing, Phil?
Well, I found some magazines under the body. Nothing special, but there were a bunch of Sailor Moon comics under there.
Wait, Sailor Moon? Isn't that that anime for preteen girls?
Well, it's not just for preteen girls.
That's besides the point. What was in the magazine?
Nothing, though a couple were laying in front of him like he was reading before he died.
Oh, I think that means he was killed by sneak attack.
How could you tell?
Well, he was stabbed in the back of his neck and his body fell forward. I thought that might mean it was a sneak attack, but the fact that he was reading magazines when he died proves it.
But what does that tell us?
Absolutely nothing. But my detective skills were pretty good, don't you think?
Hey, Pat.
Yes?
Why would Phil give us clues as to how the murder happened if he's the one who did it?
I don't know, Dimitri. Maybe we were listening. Maybe Phil's not the killer.
Okay. Hey, Pat.
Yes?
Have you ever seen The Lion King?
No.
Dimitri, for the last fucking time, I have not seen The Lion King! Okay. Well, you should. It's a classic.
Oh, really? It's a classic? Huh?
Your brother's dead, Dimitri. Okay, we can watch The Lion King later.
I know my brother's dead, all right? Doesn't mean I can't watch The Lion King.
Did anyone else find any other hints? Nothing from us.
Or us. I'm not sure we'll ever figure out who killed Tyler.
I wish I could have told him I loved him one last time. Hey, Francis. Think I can wear your top hat to the funeral?
What top hat?
The one beside your dresser. Black one.
That top hat's been in the back of my closet for at least 20 years.
So?
That means
we just found our first clue.
Stop yelling! I said I just saw the top hat. I didn't touch it or anything.
I'll get it. Everyone, wait here.
You know, it seems a little fishy that Brandon would want to take off that mask.
Now that you mention it, you're right.
Yeah, I mean, why would he want to be in that room with a vital clue?
Hey, that's what we said about you.
What?
What's about to tell me suspected, Dimitri?
You guys suspect me?
Did I say that out loud?
Oh, gee, I wonder.
How could you suspect me? I was with Darius the whole time.
Actually, Phil, I left you to take a piss.
Ooh! So it was you, Phil! Of the future! You killed my tie-dye!
Don't you all accuse me? I don't even have a reason for killing Tyler! And Darius, you fucking traitor, if you left to take a piss, then you could have easily killed him.
Yeah, but Darius wasn't in the room with Bonnie for a while like you were. You were trying to cover your tracks.
Please, I would never kill anyone. You're the crazy stalker girlfriend. That's true. She didn't leave the room while we were getting the present to wash her hands.
I always knew you were up to something, you bitch.
Get the pan.
That's why she won't date me. Because she's crazy.
Yeah!
I'm not crazy. And I didn't kill Tyler. You guys are all jealous of his love for me.
I'm not about to go around accusing anyone of anything, but I had it up to here with you all playing the blame game and shitting on me because I was looking for clues and...
Darius, what are you doing? Oh, nothing.
Really, Darius? You're live tweeting this shit!
Can you blame me? I need to keep the followers entertained.
That's true, he has a really funny Twitter.
Just found out my best friend is a serial killer. Hashtag betrayed.
See, that's a little
over-exaggerated, don't you think?
No one got famous without a little white lie.
Come on, guys, let's not get at each other's throats. Let's just wait until Brandon gets back and see if he tampered with the evidence.
Why would I tamper with the evidence?
Because we suspect you killed Tyler.
Oh.
He's looking a lot better than Phil.
Did you find anything about the hat?
Not the hat itself, but there is a letter inside of it. We just got a letter. We just got a letter. We just got a letter. Wonder who it's from.
What the fuck was that?
No. That's like from Blue's Clues.
Are you kidding me, Brandon? Okay, I'm not five. No one here would get that. No!
I know, Brandon. Set it on. The clue table.
Oh, what? We have a clue table now?
Yeah, I just came up with it. Pretty neat, huh?
There's still one piece of evidence that we haven't analyzed yet.
Oh, no, you're not thinking about
it. The only way we can analyze the body more thoroughly, we may be able to get more of a clue as to who the killer is.
We have to do it, Mo. For Tyler.
Okay, well, fine. God, just make it quick. Why doesn't Darius carry him in?
What? Why me?
Because you're strong and you're not a suspect.
You're pretty strong.
Yeah, only in your right arm, though.
And we can have Madison doing obscene things to my son's body.
Well, I don't know what obscene means, so guess the joke's on you.
Not a very funny joke, if you ask me.
Oh, you're right.
No, not yet, because how long have you motherfuckers been plotting behind my back?
Oh my god, Phil, you hold a grudge!
You straight up think I'm a murderer!
Well, Phil, this bungling barrage of backlash is because your betrayal is begging a blow for bulbous badness!
Oh yeah. Well, your three accusations of my plight are preposterous, Pat, and I pity you for prematurely putting this problem on my plate!
It's this fucking fight! fling myself off the floor and finally free myself from this farce!
If someone else stick on me, I might actually die!
Listen, Phil, it's nothing personal. It's just business.
Okay, that makes you sound like an assassin, the Matrix.
Sometimes I wish I was one.
Ooh.
Oh! I've got his body! Oh god, it smells!
And you know, I heard you shit yourself when you died.
Oh, dude.
Phil, don't say that!
Well, I've never died, so I can't say for certain.
Can I get something to cover his eyes? This is making me really uncomfortable. Thanks!
Yeah, you break them, I kill you.
Unless my dear mother kills me first.
Oh, dude.
Oh, no. No.
Oh, mercy, who, Darius?
Well, mercy, fuck you, too.
Oh. He looks so full of life, like he was just alive yesterday.
Actually, he was just alive this morning.
Really? Seems like so much longer since I last saw my buy your shoes.
Well, time isn't real anyhow.
No.
Just made it up to give structure to our chaotic lives. Oh, dude.
Oh, great going, Brandon! Hey, you came through an existential crisis!
Well, let's take a look at the body.
I'll check first!
Dude.
That's enough!
Judging by the area of the stab wound and the blood on the blankets, it looks like he was stabbed in the jugular.
What?
You know, the jugular, that vein on your neck. Everyone has one.
Unfortunately, Phil, I don't have a member of the insane clown posse on my neck.
Wait, he was stabbed near the back of his neck, further cementing our sneak attack theory.
How can that help us?
Well, and if we assume that this murder was planned in advance, then the killer probably wasn't strong enough to overpower Tyler. That's why they killed the way they did.
But who do we know who's stronger than Tyler?
I'm not sure. But I'm thinking...
What is he doing? I mean, something.
Oh my god, he's still alive!
Oh,
that's I'm pretty sure he's still dead.
Yep, uh-huh. Oh.
Oh, oh god!
I don't know. Alright, what happened? Why did he just shoot up like that?
Oh, I think it's that one thing. What's it called? Rick and Morty.
No, the sci-fi TV show with the kid and his grandpa.
Rachel McAdams.
Oh, no, that's the girl that played Regina George in Mean Girls. It's that thing that makes you stand up when you die.
Oh, it's rigor mortis.
No.
Either way, how do we get it to stop?
I think it just goes away after a while.
Oh, my god!
Let's see, can you use your right hand, okay? Hey, it looks like he's tap dancing.
Oh, dude.
Even in death, he's still trying to impress his food.
Hey, how come we never considered Tyler's boyfriend to be with Tyler?
Yeah.
He should be hung for taking Tyler away from you, though.
Well, Maddie, if it's Bowen blood you like, I've got plenty of it pumping through my veins.
Oh. You know, I can't help but feel like you can do a lot better, Dimitri.
No. I have to one-up Tyler. It'll be my final revenge for him deleting my animations.
Final revenge? As in there was revenge beforehand?
Make it some
about 8 to 12 hours.
Then I guess
it's
about 8 to 12 hours to have some fun.
But I'm the only one who gets to have fun, Tyler.
Oh,
no, we don't mean that kind of fun. We mean this kind of fun.
That's so funny, I forgot that my brother was killed today. But that's besides the point. Let's get this party back on its feet.
Fourth grade. Give me the pieces.
What?
Now go, leave the studio, and do not be prude. Go gorge thyselves on drinks and food. But don't be too long, for our show continues still until 15 past my name has been Phil.
Phil, you've really got to work on your Shakespeare.
Fine. It's intermission, everybody. Go get some drinks and pee. We'll see you in 15 minutes.